Well, hey, small group leaders, hope you're doing great. Really enjoyed the time at our small group leader huddle this week. Hope it was an encouragement to you this week. As Brandon was teaching, I had the opportunity to lead a core class, the gender and sexuality class. And in that core class, we were talking about some principles by which people make ethical decisions or validate their actions. And after the class, a couple of the group members were talking about how that concept really frames a lot of what we do in small group. And so I thought it might be helpful, just a quick aside, kind of giving you a lens or a filter by which you can press and encourage and challenge people. I'm going to use my little handy whiteboard here. So I sketched what I did in class this morning with our gender and sexuality class. When we come at ethical decisions, or when we attempt, we were talking about homosexuality this morning and the challenge that we have, and wrestling through perspective, or really pressing with people, whether it's same-sex attraction or any type of sexual sin issue, and how people attempt to validate their actions. And one of the points I was making in the class this morning is that when we're attempting to figure out what's right or wrong in life, there's really four bases on which we make decisions. We filter right and wrongness through four primary lenses, and everybody does this, whether believer or non-believer alike, though the scripture piece may be a little bit different. But experience, I feel like, or I know someone who I want to, so the experience-based decision-making, some type of sacred text. The Bible says this is right or wrong, this should be or shouldn't be, but it doesn't just have to be the Bible. It could be any type of sacred scripture or any type of writing that someone holds high or esteems. Reason, I think, or it makes sense that. So in the case of homosexuality, as we were talking about this morning, well, someone might argue, well, it makes sense that God's design would simply be that two people would love one another regardless of what gender is in play in the relationship. And then tradition. Tradition would say, my culture says, my church says, my subgroup within culture says, whatever. Okay, so these are the four pillars or the four bases by which people determine right and wrong. And one of the things we were thinking through in our class this morning is how these stack up, or how these are weighted in people's sense of what they should or should not do. So the way most people are going to come out evaluating these four is something like the pie chart model that's here on the dry erase board. So they're going to put all four of these into a pie chart and give them all some percentage weight. So in the case of homosexuality, often the discussion begins with their experience. I feel like I was born this way. This is what my natural desire is. Or I know someone who feels this way. So they may weight experience this larger pie chunk here. They may say, you know, X percentage is going to be filtered through experience. Then I'm going to give a sacred scripture some weight. I'm going to give reason some weight, and I'm going to give tradition some weight. And we do this with all of our decisions, discernment about anything in life. This is a faulty model, and gets you in a lot of trouble when it comes to discerning right and wrong, to give each of these four the same basis of weight. In model number two, a better model is to put these in some type of tipped over pyramid, you might say. So moving across the pyramid perspective, experience, scripture, reason, tradition. Now, I've intentionally done this in what I think is a poor order, but to show you that you might say, well, my experience is the norm to begin with. It gets the most weight. And then I read scripture through the lens of my experience. We talked about this with divorce and remarriage a few weeks ago, how we filter our own personal experiences, or we filter scripture through the lens of our personal experiences, then reason, than tradition. I actually think what is a far better parameter or guideline for those of us who are in the church is actually to erase these. And as good biblicists, as those who hold scripture as our sacred text, the scriptures then become the defining norm. They become the standard by which everything else is judged or evaluated. And everything else gets filtered through the lens of our experience. Secondly, I believe that tradition is perhaps the second best pillar for us. Why? Because tradition, or the history of the church particularly, or even the history of our church community here, is multiple voices and multiple perspectives rather than my own. So my own experience and reason is depraved, it's fallen, and therefore it's prone to get me in all sorts of trouble. At least tradition, I have a community of voices, multiple people who are speaking to any issue. So one of the points I made in the homosexuality teaching this morning is that throughout the history of the Christian church, it's been uniformly true that homosexuality was condemned. So when we see something that's overwhelmingly condemned in that way, it helps us understand. Perhaps it's not the defining norm, because a group of people can be wrong. Sacred scripture is primary to that, but tradition does matter. And then our reason and experience get filtered through last. They become the last bases for our experience. And we have to say that based on the lordship of Jesus Christ, our experience and even our fallen reasoning, well, what makes logical sense to us gets pressed down under the lordship of Jesus Christ. We have to submit that to the sacred scriptures. And if there's nowhere where the scriptures are provoking us in ways that don't make sense or ways that we don't like, we would have to question our interpretation of scripture, because by virtue of our fallenness, we would expect the Bible to consistently poke and prod us in these ways. Now, why film a video and talk to small group leaders? Because I think in my own gender accountability time with the guys in my small group, this is what we're talking about all the time. Be it parenting, be it in our marriages, be it with our finances, whatever the right or wrong decision is that we're battling through at any given moment, I'm attempting to filter the conversation through the lens of these four categories. What does Scripture say? Then what does the community of believers here in this room say? And then how do we interpret our own experience or reason through that lens? So my hope is that whatever the issue is that your small group is pressing on, or those that you're discipling or working through, it may not be sexual morality or homosexuality, but whatever the issue is, that you can help people see their faulty basis for decision makings and press them to a high view of scripture that then defines every other basis of decision making through that lens. Hope that's helpful to you this week as you teach and lead and press into God's people. Love you guys. Pray for you this week.